Thank you. far I can go, a fountain. I'd like to invite all of you to come to a project program that I'm a part of that's in February. The name of the project is 2-4-3. Now, 2-4 comes from February the 4th, which happens to be my birthday, Vincent Chancey's birthday, and John Stubblefield's birthday. And from the early 80s, when I first met Stubbs, it was with Reggie Workman's band, Top Shelf. And we talked about, I mean, we need to do a gig on our birthdays. And we said that, and then Vincent had met John separately in his own way. And Vincent said, yeah, man, we should do birthdays. So we talked about it for years, and 2005 came up, and John Stubblefield left us for the big man. But it turned out that as I was doing research on my family, Vincent was doing research on his family. And our good friend, arts producer, Jeanette Volko, knew both of us were doing the work. We didn't know it, so she said, well, why don't you two of you get together? So we got together, and we're on February 4th, 2018. We have a gig on our birthday. And it will be at Roulette. Roulette's performance space, Atlantic Avenue, downtown Brooklyn. Keep an eye out for it. You can put 2-4-18 in your calendar, and so that you can come and give us support. Our joining us will be Maria Mitchell in dance, and Marvin Sewell on guitar. So, and we have Bill Tolles is going to be doing visuals and lighting. So it's just a whole brand new thing for me and for Vincent. We haven't tried this kind of thing before, but we're looking forward to doing this, and hope that you will be able to find your way. And if you can't come, send us up. We feel welcome. So actually you can send an enemy. And afterward, he might be your friend. So we'll see. Okay, we're gonna go conclude with a black string band tune. And in case you don't know what a string band black string band was, it comes from, actually started out with violin, the fiddler on the plantation, who played for dances and celebrations on the plantation for the slave owner and also for the slaves themselves. And it grew from violin to violin and banjo, and percussion, spoons, playing your body, bones, pots and pans of biscuits, rocks, various things. This is an aside, but my people are very, really inventive and find ways to make something out of nothing. So in that tradition, the black string band grew and became the kind of music for plantations, and after in the late 19th century, it was recorded. And when they first started recording, they were recording black string bands, and it lasted, went up until around the Depression, and then that was the end of recording black bands, string bands. So we're playing, this is a tune that we'll eventually get to it. and it's called John Brown's Dream. And I'm not sure the exact dates, but 1800s, 1700s. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.